CEO Elon Musk says that SpaceX is about to begin the construction of a much larger high bay. Adjacent to the existing structure, an 82 meters, approximately 270 feet tall, building used to complete assembly of Starship and Super Heavy boosters. According to Musk, the newest addition to SpaceX's arsenal of Starship production facilities will be located just north of an existing high bay. Boca Chica's high bay is tall enough for SpaceX to use a bridge crane to stack 50 meters, 165 feet Starships, and approximately 70 meters, approximately 230 feet Super Heavy boosters, far more efficient and protected than using wheeled or tracked cranes to assemble rockets out in the open. Construction of the existing high bay began in May 2020 and was more or less complete by the start of 2021. The structure was truly finished in April 2021 with the installation of a heavy-duty bridge crane, though work continues to this day, on what CEO Elon Musk has described as a bar and viewing area to be located at the top of the bay. Musk's assertion that the new facility will be much larger can be interpreted a number of ways. There's a distant possibility that SpaceX will build a true NASA-style vehicle assembly building, like the colossal VAB used to fully assembled Saturn V, and the Space Shuttle at Kennedy Space Center. For Starship, that would require a structure at least approximately 130 meters tall, more than 50% taller than the current high bay. More likely, Musk means that SpaceX will effectively be building a second similarly tall high bay, but with far more usable floor space. The existing structure is large enough to fit four or far different Starship, or Super Heavy, stacks at once, though SpaceX's current setup appears to allow two vehicle sections to be stacked and worked on simultaneously. In his July 25 tweet, Musk implicitly noted that SpaceX does have a significant amount of mostly unused space that could be perfect for another assembly building directly north of the high and mid bays. Generally speaking, SpaceX has a plot of land around 170 meters, approximately 560 by 190 meters, approximately 620, that's currently half used as a Starship scrapyard and overflow lot, but most of the space is empty. Even if SpaceX only turned half of that land into a sort of vertical Starship assembly line, it would still boost high bay floor space by at least a factor of 5 or 6, and possibly 8 to 10x. With that much extra space enclosed in a permanent structure, it's likely that this new facility could mark a new evolution in SpaceX's ever-changing Starship factory. Elon Musk says that SpaceX's second Starship high bay will be a little taller than the first, but have a much bigger base and multiple gantry bridge cranes that will run the full length of the building. SpaceX is working to develop the Starship launch system that will enable humans to set foot on the Red Planet. This might sound like a science fiction plot to many, but SpaceX employees work every day towards making life multiplanetary. It appears that consciousness is a very rare and precious thing, and we should take whatever steps we can to preserve the light of consciousness, says SpaceX founder Elon Musk. He envisions a fleet of Starships transporting cargo and hundreds of passengers to build the first colony on the Martian surface before the year 2050. Colonizing another planet will be humanity's greatest challenge. To achieve this ambitious venture, SpaceX will have to innovate quickly and have a rapid production rate. Musk says that in order to make a self-sustaining permanent colony on Mars' surface, the company will have to manufacture enough Starships to transport megatons of cargo over the course of the next 20 years. Building approximately 1,000 Starships to create a self-sustaining city on Mars is our mission, Musk said last year. Building 100 Starships per year gets to 1,000 in 10 years, or 100 megatons per year, or maybe around 100,000 people, per Earth-Mars orbital sink, he stated. The Starship spacecraft and Super Heavy rocket booster will become the world's most powerful rocket, equipped with a total of 39 Raptors. These engines are specially designed by SpaceX, powered by Methalox, a combination of cryogenic liquid methane fuel and liquid oxygen oxidizer, that operate in a full-flow staged combustion cycle. Building this engine is a delicate process, because engineers must develop fully reusable and efficient engines. On July 26, SpaceX announced it achieved production of 100 Raptor engines for the Starship launch vehicle. To celebrate the achievement, SpaceX shared a photograph of its employees posing with the 100th Raptor at the company's headquarters in Hawthorne, California, in front of the display of the first Falcon 9 rocket that ever landed. Raptor engines are shipped to Texas, where SpaceX is developing Starship at its Starbase facility. Engineers are preparing to conduct the first orbital flight test, that will require to equip a Super Heavy booster prototype with 29 Raptor engines, and Starship with 6 Raptors, 3 will be vacuum-optimized for propulsion in space. To boost production rate, SpaceX will set up a new Raptor engine manufacturing factory soon. "We are breaking ground soon on a second Raptor factory at SpaceX Texas test site," Musk said. The factory will be located in McGregor, Texas, where SpaceX currently manufactures and tests the Falcon 9 Merlin engines. This will focus on volume production of Raptor 2, while California factory will make Raptor vacuum and new, experimental designs, he said. "By volume production, I mean 2 to 4 engines per day. That's super high volume for big rocket engines, but low volume by automotive standards," Musk added. Long term, he said that SpaceX targets to manufacture roughly 800 to 1,000 engines per year. That's about what's needed over 10 years to create the fleet to build a self-sustaining city on Mars. City itself probably takes roughly 20 years, so hopefully it is built by /2050, Musk said. NASA awarded SpaceX a $2.89 billion human landing system contract to develop a lunar-optimized Starship to land astronauts on the Moon, as part of the Artemis program. Blue Origins, the national team, and Dynetics were also competing for this award. The agency selected SpaceX as the sole HLS contract winner. Then Boeing filed a protest against the contract, stating they believed it was unfair, because NASA initially intended to select at least 2 companies to work on returning astronauts to the lunar surface. However, SpaceX is the only company that offered NASA a fully reusable launch system, capable of transporting both astronauts and a significant amount of cargo, unlike its competitors that only designed a lander capsule that needs to be launched atop a separate rocket. Starship will be capable of in-orbit refueling, to fly between the surface and lunar orbit many times. The vehicle can also be used to build a permanent base. Astronauts would be able to work and sleep inside Starship's pressurized cabin, on the Moon. NASA says it decided to select one company because of budget constraints. Congress only approved $850 million for the HLS program in fiscal year 2021. In June, the U.S. Senate passed a new bill that would require NASA to select 2 companies for the HLS lander, if the U.S. House of Representatives approved the funding bill. Initially, Boeing proposed a cost of $5.99 billion to develop its lunar lander for NASA, which is roughly double the cost of SpaceX's HLS contract proposal. On Monday, July 26, Blue Origin founder Jeff Bezos wrote an open letter to NASA Administrator Bill Nelson, in which he requests a chance to compete with SpaceX. Bezos is now offering to cover up to $2 billion in lunar lander development costs, if NASA gives the national team a chance to compete with SpaceX's lunar lander. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.